Everybody, my name is Amari, and my mom Jessica, and me and my mom Jessica are making a cup for my teacher because tomorrow is Valentine's Day.
Yep. Right now, I'm mixing epoxy on my favorite tool, my candle warmer. There are plenty of bubbles in here, but that's okay because, as usual, we're going to take care of that later. Amari is going to be doing the decorative work here. She's going to pour. Well, I'm going to help her apply the epoxy, but she's going to add the coloring on her own. And she's 10.
Yes.
And this will be her first project.
And if you want to learn how to make alcohol ink, you can go to Jessica Craftings and make sure you like, subscribe, and type a comment if needed.
Yep. Any questions you have, comments, input? If you like the videos, tell me. If you don't like them, tell me why and what I can do to make them better.
And also, ring the bell button. Ring the bell so you can get notifications every single time my mom posts a video.
Yeah. All right, so we're mixed, and as you can see, ultra bubbly. But it's not a bad thing.
And we're not caring about the bubbles because, as usual, we do it later.
Indeed. All right, so now comes the fun part. Now this is hot.
Okay.
So I'm going to turn on the turner. Okay. As the cup is turning, I'm going to pour it, and you just use your finger to spread it out, and I'll help you out with that.
Okay.
So we're ready? Just smooth it around. There you go. You got to work a little fast sometimes. Ooh. Don't push down too hard. You want to use a light finger.
Okay.
Like, well, let me show you. Don't worry about the size. You just want the top to make sure. Catch it.
Oh,
I'm sorry.
It's okay.
Slow down. Not too fast. Oh, be careful. Oh, I don't want it to drip on the thing. All right. Hold on. Can you just do this real quick? Hold on. This mix was, this is a 30-ounce tumbler, and I used 20 milliliters of epoxy, 10 of part A, 10 of part B, just to have a thick enough layer that it will be smooth and go on smooth in the first round.
The epoxy smells like dog poop. It's so terrible. Why does
it doesn't have a smell to me?
It does.
Really?
Smell your finger.
I think that's probably a combination with the glove or something.
It smells terrible.
Because this epoxy, I love it because we can use it inside without any issue.
Yeah, it's not that strong. You have to actually put your fingers up.
Yeah.
Just a reminder for any new viewers, I am Jessica's daughter, and we are making a cup for my teacher.
Hey, Michelle.
Oh, we're from New Jersey originally, not too far from you. All right, so right now, there are some bubbles in here, and this is where my handy dandy heat gun comes in. It's gonna help out gas and kill the bubbles. Yes, this motor is the, I forgot the name of it. It's from Amazon. It's a barbecue rotisserie, but when I went to look and when I went to get more, I did not see them at all on Amazon. I don't know if they're not making them, or I think a char broil or char grill. They have them at Walmart too. And being that it's, I want to say because it's winter, they're on sale. So a lot of people have been getting them for like $5 or a dollar. At some point, I'm going to upload a video on how to make a turner. I have the parts, just haven't put it together yet. Yes, Junior?
Why are no numbers there?
I didn't fill it in yet. All right. So epoxy's on. Bubbles are mostly. Just a minute. The bubbles are mostly gone. This is the ink that I made. It's orange. Her teacher's favorite color is orange. So I'm gonna hand it over and let Amari apply. There you go. Now what you want to do is just kind of drip it on like I did in like we did in the other video. Don't touch yet. Just don't let it touch the epoxy. And then you just go up and down. Not too much, not too much. Okay, wait. Now go. Oh. Too close, too close. Are you comfortable? Okay. Yes, Junior.
Can you take a superhero
I got it. No, you gotta stay here.
tattoo?
Hold on, baby. I actually like the way you did it.
It looks like orange cream.
It does look like orange cream. Yes, Junior.
Can you take a superhero tattoo?
Yes, I'll type in superhero tycoon.
Someone
Yeah,
right
that's okay. Damn, why are you pinching
there.
Okay.
Mommy.
Now I'm gonna throw the heat gun on here and get that epoxy to keep moving. He's up there. He's up there. Now, one, I feel like I can do some manipulating. I haven't done this before, so this is going to be an experiment. So I kind of want to see what happens.
Swirls.
Yeah, maybe we can. Yep, just do a big one right there. Don't push it too hard because yeah, since it's still moving, it might give us a cool effect.
Hold
on first.
I'm going to Then you put it in the fridge to make it cool.
That's right. If you put it in the fridge, you'll make it cool.
Yeah, it was hot. So put your gloves on.
That's right. But these aren't the heat. These are not the heat gloves. These are to keep the yucky stuff off our fingers.
Mm-hmm.
Came out kind of cool. I actually like that. All right, we got to experiment and come up with a new method. Junior, don't do that. Watch your fingers, though. It's hot. All right, that looks pretty awesome. Now, what I like to do, which you can't really see here, but it looks good on the top, but I like to go look down under when you're doing your tumblers. I know we're touching, because that's where you'll find drips. So if there's a heavy piece, if there's a heavy chunk of epoxy that's resting somewhere, it's going to keep sliding to the bottom. So you come down and you make sure that everything looks even. There's no drips down there, because that will catch you later and it will suck. And you'll have to either strip it or sand like you've never sanded before. This is the first step. This is like the third step, because first we washed our tumblers, then we dried them, applied primer, let that dry. And just now you got to see the epoxy stage. Right now I'm just catching any bubbles that I might see in here. I'll show you that later. All right, now I could use the heat gun forever. Well, as we know from previous video, that would take 25 minutes and it's past dinner time. So right now I'm gonna show you all my next favorite way of helping the epoxy cure is the heat light. Take off your glove. Thank you. Sorry. Okay. I got this off of Amazon. I'll show you
really
first.
Big orangey reddish light.
Yeah.
That makes everything super hot. Trust me, I put my hand under it.
They come jacked up. It's only aluminum, so thankfully it's not too big of an issue. Yeah. But there's the lamp. The light bulb itself came separately. It's a Philips HeatRay 250 watt infrared heat lamp. It is awesome. Usually I use a space heater, but after discovering this heat lamp, I don't have a problem with ripples, and it dries so much faster. So that's the lamp. I just have it hanging on a piece of a makeshift wood shelf that I made. And ignore my corner. If it comes into view, this is how it looks, and I'll tell you how far it is from the lamp. It is about 13 to 14 inches away from the heat lamp. And I'll tell you what temperature it is. I'll tell you what temperature it is. Oh, there it is.
It is 118.0.
Wait, which part?
Oh.
Yeah. The light bulb itself right now is about 249 degrees Fahrenheit. The cup is 109.1 Fahrenheit. This is Promarine Epoxy. This brand's amazing. They say you can heat it up to 160, I believe. If my memory serves me correctly. If it doesn't, I'll update and I'll put that information in the description. And that'll help the process along. And oh, I see more bubbles. Oh, dark. Gotta plug it back in. Okay. Let's see. Bubbles. All right. So we are bubble free, smooth. There's a black imperfection. I'm just going to leave that for now because it's going to be covered in the next layer. Yeah, and that's it. So I will be back live again for round two, and I'll let you all know how long this took to cure or dry while it was under the light. Thanks for watching.